Hello friends, today let us understand more about the working of a magnetic recorder. A magnetic recorder is known to all of us. A typical example is a cassette. What are the various parts of a cassette? Maybe very interesting part of a magnetic recorder is its magnetic tape, right? You all might have seen it. It is a long thin sheet of plastic, and one thing you cannot see on a magnetic tape is that a magnetic material is coated onto the magnetic tape. This thin sheet of plastic actually contains a deposition of iron oxide or any other kind of magnetic material. So let us understand more about the working of a magnetic recorder. The various parts of a magnetic recorder are a recording head, magnetic head, reproducing head, tape transport mechanism, and conditioning devices. Let's understand the schematic diagram of the working of a magnetic recorder. Here you can see various parts of it. The main part that you can notice here is the cassette itself. This is the cassette. These are the two small circles you can see on a cassette, which is the transport mechanism. And the major part of a magnetic recorder is its magnetic tape. You now know about magnetic tape. Then the other parts are a recording head and a reproducing head. Recording head functions while we are recording something onto the magnetic tape, and the reproducing head functions while we are receiving something, retrieving some data from the magnetic recorder. So these are the two heads on the magnetic tape. Then we have a channel for giving some input signal, and the input signal is fed into the recording head. And we have a channel to take the output signal along with an amplifier. The output signal is taken from the reproducing head. And while we are recording the data, the magnetic tape will be moving from along one direction, and the signal will be encoded onto the magnetic tape as magnetic data. And while we are receiving data from the magnetic recorder, the tape will be moving along the opposite direction, and the reproducing head will be reading the data from the magnetic tape and giving us back the output signal. This is the basic functioning of a magnetic recorder. Now let us look more into the working of the recording head and the reproducing head. Here you can see the schematic diagram of a recording head as well as a reproducing head. In a recording head, the input signal is fed into a coil, and the coil will produce variations in magnetic flux along its core depending on the input signal. That is a basic law from electrodynamics, the Faraday's law. Whenever the voltage corresponding to a coil is varying, the magnetic flux associated with it, with the coil, will also be varying. So we will have a continuous variation of magnetic flux along this coil, including the reproducing head, so the recording head, depending on the variations in signal. So this variation in magnetic flux will be encoded onto the magnetic tape, which is present here. The magnetic tape will be moving along one direction, and the variation in the magnetic flux will be recorded onto the magnetic tape. So we will finally have a sheet of magnetic tape on which various variation in magnetic flux is encoded. Each part of the magnetic tape will be permanently magnetized depending on the magnetization applied. So this is how we encode a data onto the magnetic tape. Now let's look how the data is reproduced from a magnetic tape. The working is exactly opposite to that of a recording head. In a reproducing head, the magnetic tape will be moving along the other direction. This moving magnetic tape contains some variation in magnetic flux encoded as permanent magnetization on it, and the variation in magnetization of the magnetic tape will be identified by this reproducing head. So here we will have some flux variation depending on the variations encoded on the magnetic tape, and this flux variation in turn will produce variations in voltage along this coil. That is the exact reverse process that we have already mentioned. So we have some variation in voltage associated with the coil that we can take out. That is our output signal. So this is how a reproducing head functions. Now, we all know how a magnetic tape or a region or containing some magnetic material gets magnetized. The magnetic tape also follows the hysteresis loop. While recording, we are applying some magnetic field onto the magnetic material, so it will get magnetized. Here we can see, depending on the externally applied magnetic field, a magnetization is produced on the material of the magnetic tape, right? So if we apply a magnetic field of this amount, of this quantity, then even after we remove the magnetic field, the material will contain this much amount of magnetization. That is called retentivity, right? The magnetic material on the magnetic tape will retain its magnetization. It will be permanently magnetized. But what will happen if we apply a lower amount of magnetic field? Even then, it will contain a little amount of magnetization. So, depending on the amount of external magnetic field applied or the magnitude of the external magnetic field applied, the material will retain some amount of magnetization. So, throughout the magnetic tape, there will be variation in magnetization being recorded. One point to be noted here is that in this process of direct recording, the relationship between externally applied magnetic field and the magnetization produced on the recording material is not linear, because hysteresis loop is not linear. Depending on the magnetic field, externally applied magnetic field, the material will have a non-linear magnetization. That is one problem associated with direct recording. If we want to get a linear relationship between externally applied magnetic field and the magnetization produced, we need to use FM recording or PDM recording, pulse duration modulation recording. There are three modes of magnetic recording as indicated. In this lecture, we have learned about the working of direct recording. I hope that you understood how a magnetic recorder functions. Thank you.